Words the whole world has been waiting to hear, spoken just moments ago to CNN. It is the start of the end of the pandemic, quote. That from the brains behind BioNTech. Remember, that vaccine developed in partnership between them and Pfizer. CNN's Fred Pleitgen has been speaking to the BioNTech CEO and is connecting us now to the very latest on the vaccine. What do they tell you, Fred?
Hi there, Becky. Of course, they're ecstatic here at BioNTech, and the vaccine was really developed right in the labs that you see behind me, in the building that you see behind me. And the CEO of BioNTech, Ugur Sahin, he told me, of course, they worked day and night. And one of the things that's interesting that Salma was just saying, he said, absolutely, the UK regulators, all the regulators, have been in touch with BioNTech this entire time, posting questions, requesting more information. So this is a process that's been ongoing. But one of the things they said with this emergency use approval in the United Kingdom, they said that the process there was every bit as professional as it is in the United States, as it is in the European Union as well. So he says that folks in the UK can be certain they are going to get a very safe vaccine, and when we're certainly the regulator has kept a very sharp eye on what exactly is going on. Now, he said that the process now is going to go very quickly. Shipments are going to be going to the UK within a matter of days, and then people will get jabs in their arms probably at the beginning of next week. And he did also indeed say that he believes that this could be the beginning of the end of the coronavirus pandemic. Let's listen in.
It will be the first time that people outside of clinical trials will get access to our vaccine. And we believe that it is really the start of the end of the pandemic if we can ensure now a broad rollout of our vaccine. Of course, it's the first country to enable an authorization, and others will probably follow. Yeah, but it's a good start. So if everything goes well, I expect that first people could get the first vaccinations beginning next week. I personally believe with a number of companies now reaching the approval in the next few months, we might be able to deliver sufficient number of doses until end of summer 2021 to reach the 60 to 70% coverage, which could give us the relief to have a normal winter in 2021.
So the end of summer 2021 is when people, he believes, could really be feeling the difference, when life essentially could really start returning to normal, is what the CEO of BioNTech believes. And there was one other really interesting thing, Becky, that he told me as well. Of course, one of the things that we've been speaking about so much in the past couple of days is the fact that this Pfizer and BioNTech vaccine needs to be stored and needs to be shipped at around minus 100 Fahrenheit, around minus 70, minus 75 Celsius. Well, he says they're already working on a new formulation of the vaccine to try and get it shipped possibly even at room temperatures to make sure that that whole shipping process becomes easier as well. They're also checking the vaccine further to see whether it could possibly be shipped at not quite as cold temperatures already in the not too distant future, but they say also by the sort of middle of next year, towards the end of next year, they'll have a new formulation in place just to make that whole logistics process a little easier as well, to make sure they can ship even more to more places around the world, Becky.
Yeah, and I know you've been at distribution centers exploring the challenges that the distribution of this vaccine puts up around the world. I mean, people do want it distributed around the world. There are challenges to the logistics of doing that, and we will explore those in the days and weeks to come. Thank you for that. So that's the latest in Europe, but that's far from the whole story on vaccines, because when I say this is a global quest, I mean it. Like, for example, in China, where hundreds of thousands of people already vaccinated there with the country's own homegrown vaccine. You will remember that they are also holding large trials here in the UAE. The Sinopharm trial, for example, and we are working away to bring you news on that, because we do not have these Chinese vaccine trial results as of yet. CNN's David Culver has been getting an exclusive look into the infrastructure that is already in place in China to get that vaccine sent around the world. He's out in Shenzhen for us today. David?
Becky, you've been looking at the vaccine distribution within the U.S., within the U.K., and other parts of Europe. It's going to look a little differently here in China. They're going to be focused not so much on the domestic rollout, but global distribution. Now, not all of this is rooted in goodwill. Chinese companies that are behind the vaccines that are eventually approved will certainly benefit financially from this. And some look at this as an opportunity for China to repair what is perceived as a tarnished image after its initial handling of the outbreak. Nonetheless, they have to prepare to distribute. And the companies behind that distribution already are in place and ready to roll it out.
You're looking at one of the cargo jets that will soon be taking vaccines that are approved here in China, made by Chinese biotech companies, to the rest of the world. This one is a charter, Ethiopian cargo. It's their pharma wing. Look over here. You can see they're already loading up some of the PPE, some of the face masks, some of the hazmat-like suits. Inside, however, they have built an infrastructure that is temperature and climate controlled. Why does that matter? Well, as soon as the vaccines are approved, they have to be kept at a certain temperature setting. And that is the only way they can be transferred from start here in Shenzhen in southern China to finish. For this aircraft, it continues on to the Middle East. One thing that's important to note is the logo on the side, China. That is a part of Alibaba. It's their logistics and distribution part. Normally, they're doing goods that people are buying online. Think of Amazon, but on a massive scale. That is the company that here in China is helping with the distribution of vaccines as soon as they're given the go-ahead.
We are ready to move the vaccines.
Sinel CEO Juan Lin says the company is now adding more routes for greater global reach.
We are not still quite sure about the exact demand on that, but we are definitely building our capability to be prepared for that.
While China is yet to approve a vaccine for public use, Sinel says their end-to-end climate-controlled infrastructure is in place and ready. The required temperature, which differs depending on the vaccine, must be maintained throughout transport, from leaving the production facility to airport storage, and finally, to global cargo distribution.
For example, the Shenzhen Airport Terminal, they have already set up a cold chain warehouse, mainly for the medicine suppliers.
CNN got an exclusive look inside that cold chain facility, which will soon store the approved vaccines.
Now, these chambers can be specified and even customized based on the required temperature for each vaccine. And they can put them in different chambers within so as to accommodate that.
Sinel then works with different airlines to ensure the cargo temperature is sustained throughout the flight. In this case, Ethiopian Airlines. Since the start of the pandemic, they've flown more than 3,000 tons of supplies to Europe, Africa, the Middle East, and South America.
So we do the same also for the vaccine to distribute to all destinations around the globe. And then we cure a lot of human beings.
It certainly sounds promising, but the reality is all of this is dependent on a vaccine being approved here in China. Now, where you are, Becky, in Abu Dhabi, we know that Chinese vaccines have been part of some of the clinical trials. But the biotech companies behind these vaccines, they face some challenges. There's skepticism over their lack of transparency at times, and there's questions over how effective the vaccines really are. If they can win back some of that trust globally, then we know companies like Alibaba's Sinel are ready to start shipping immediately. Becky.